A couple of years ago, I made a video showing enhancements which I had made to my fire pit. The purpose of those enhancements was to help eliminate smoke and produce a more productive fire. That video received over 250,000 views to date. A link to that video is provided at the top of your screen. The most common concern expressed by my viewers was the restriction of airflow due to my use of pea gravel and a large paver stone which were positioned under my fire ring. There were also quite a few who expressed concern about the possibility of noise from the blower that I used to force air into my Dakota-style design. As a brief overview of my initial design, I mounted a 12-volt bilge blower in a plastic tote. I cut 2 4-inch holes on both sides of the tote so that I could connect dryer vent hose to the inlet and the outlet sides of the blower. I then created a Dakota-style trench on the side of my fire pit, and I extended the trench directly under the pit in order to introduce fresh air into the pit. I attached the dryer vent hose from the blower to a 2-foot section of galvanized pipe. I then connected a vented rain cap, which was positioned directly under my fire pit. In order to test the performance of the blower, I had temporarily connected the battery to my mower. Some of the viewers mistakenly thought that this was how I intended to power the blower. They commented that this idea was ridiculous. I could not agree more. In reality, the blower is supplied power from my wind turbine. The power to my blower is controlled by a wireless remote, which connects or disconnects power by way of a radio frequency relay. The remote control relay permits me to wirelessly control my blower while sitting around the fire. The on-off remote switch and relay are demonstrated here using a computer fan, which is powered by a regular 9-volt battery. To connect the blower to the battery in my wind-powered energy station, I trenched a ditch from my in-ground plastic tote to my energy station. I then ran wires to the interior of the station in order to connect them to my power source. The wires from the blower are first connected to a low voltage disconnect module. The purpose of this module is to automatically disconnect power from my 12-volt battery whenever the battery's voltage drops below an acceptable threshold. My battery receives its power from my homemade wind turbine. The turbine's energy input is regulated by a Colmenaire charge controller. The charge controller prevents overcharging of the battery and it helps prolong the battery's life. Before putting my fire ring back in place, I decided that I needed some gravel to prevent wood ash from making its way into the ductwork and clogging up airflow. I therefore backfilled the pit with pea gravel. Because the tire rim has a large hole in the center, I decided to place a large paver stone on top of the gravel, which I placed above the vented cap. After setting the tire rim in place, I backfilled the space around the outer circumference of the tire rim with even more pea gravel. Once I got all my enhancements in place and started testing my fire pit, I thought my results were fairly impressive. Here you can see the difference between a campfire, which is burning without any forced air, compared to a fire that is being stoked with air forced by my running bilge blower. Even though I was convinced that my fire pit design was a success, I could not help to think that it would be much better if I eliminated a lot of that fill material which allegedly was choking airflow to my fire pit. So I decided to see if my viewers were correct. I determined to test the popular opinion of my viewers by removing the paver and the pea gravel and replaced it with, well, just watch the following segment as I reveal my design change. After that, I'm going to show you the surprising outcome. Spoiler alert, it was a result that caught me totally off guard, something I did not anticipate. We're going to get into the results of the fire test. Prior to doing that, I wanted to put to rest the issue of sound levels caused by the blower. So I positioned my iPhone between the fire pit and the tree. Right below the base of the tree is where the intake is. So this is the position where it would pick up the most noise.
All right, so this is ambient sound. The decibel meter is picking up around 59 at a peak. I think I saw maybe 60. But this is, I would say, 4 feet away from the center of the fire pit, so a lot closer than probably anyone would sit when the fire is going on. So we're going to go ahead and turn on the blower, and we're going to see the difference. All right, the blower is on. And I'm seeing relatively the same readings. So relatively very little difference between when the blower is running and when it's not running. So all of the comments, and there is quite a few of them, indicating that the fire pit is too noisy to be able to enjoy the ambience of the fire, I think those are all unfounded. Okay, we've got a good productive flame. I don't have the blower on at this point, so I'm going to turn it on and see if some of that smoke there goes away. So here we go, let's turn that on. Blower is on at this point. And as before, the reduction of smoke isn't immediate, but as the blower runs, it kind of stokes the flame and the flame eliminates smoke. Now some of these logs are a little bit wet, so they're gonna smoke a little bit. You're not gonna eliminate 100% of the smoke in any campfire, but the object is to reduce smoke. So let that blower run a little bit. Getting smoke mainly from the tops of those logs, but the fire is pretty productive. I'm going to go ahead and turn this back off. Blower is off at this point. Don't see a whole lot of difference in the height of the flame. This is a pretty fresh fire. I started it maybe, I don't know, 10 minutes ago. I'm gonna try it again. I'll turn on the blower and see if we can notice any difference in the height of the flame. So this is blower on now. Blower is on. I must admit, I'm not seeing a whole lot of difference between the two. Perhaps maybe a little less smoke, but it seems that the fire is just as productive, whether the fan or the blower is on or not. I'm just wondering now, since I've kind of eliminated all that gravel and that paver, whether it's getting enough draw from the pipe to act as a true Dakota fire pit, and whether the blower is unnecessary at this point.
To save you the time of watching the repeated test that I did, observing the flames with the blower on and then comparing that to the intensity of the fire with no assistance from the blower, suffice it to say that the fire performed well, whether or not it was assisted by the bilge blower. So my conclusion, the bilge blower is helpful to fan the flames when starting a fire or when the fire is diminishing and needs to be rekindled. However, once the fire pit is heated and the fire is fully productive, the rising heat within the fire pit is able to pull ample air through the underground ductwork, rendering the blower as unnecessary.
So with that, I guess we'll wrap things up today. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like. That will tell the YouTube algorithms that this is good content and more people should see it. If you haven't subscribed yet, please take the opportunity to do so. Hey, thanks for watching today, and we'll see you next time.